In all the talk about banning the garment from federal parliament, they of course did back down on that proposal, but many saw it as fear-mongering and an unjust attack on Muslim women.
Well, now a moving social experiment captured on hidden cameras proves Australians are perhaps more tolerant than we might have thought. Watch their reactions to an actor who heckles Muslims on Sydney streets.
Why can't he just dress like normal Australians? Is there a bomb in here?
Just leave me alone.
Look at this guy, like, you look like a terrorist, seriously. Just, can you see this stuff?
Wear what he wants.
Like, everywhere they go, they blow stuff up.
No, man, let him wear what he wants.
Look at him, like, look how he's dressed.
That's all right. Any different to what you've got on. He's chosen his dress, you've chosen yours. I've chosen mine.
Whatever, these people.
That's Australia, you can wear whatever you want.
Exactly, this is Australia, man.
No,
what?
If he wants to wear that, let him wear that. It's fine, there's no problem with it.
Like, everywhere they go, they blow stuff up.
Are you kidding?
Like, look at them. Like, he looks like a terrorist, seriously.
He's a 10-year-old kid, leave him alone.
Why do you care about these people so much?
Like, what are you talking about?
Like, look at them.
Can you leave him alone?
What's in the bag, mate? Do you have a bomb in there? Yeah, I don't trust you a lot. What's in the bloody bag? Give it to me, mate. Like, what is this? Bloody Muslims, everywhere you go, you blow stuff up. Do you see these people? Like, look at how he's dressed.
Leave him alone. Everybody has a right to be here. Don't you dare speak to people like that. How dare you?
Do you support these people?
Yes. Why not? Free people. These people belong here too, as much as we do. All right?
Seriously.
If you don't like it, go live somewhere else. But
whatever.
These people belong here. He's a kid. How dare you? How dare you do that to him?
Whatever.
Go and live somewhere else if you don't can't accept this from.
And several members of our team have admitted to getting very teary watching that. I may or may not have been one of them. Quite amazing stuff, and we're delighted to be joined now by the creators of that video, Kamal Saleha and Abir Hassan. Thank you so much for coming in. And an incredible social experiment.
Thank you so much. Thank you for
Abir, it's obviously you in the video there. Did you have any idea what you were going to be faced with when you went out and did this?
We had an idea that we were going to get some responses, but to be honest, the kind of overwhelming response we got, we weren't expecting it at all.
Mm. Every single person that stopped and saw what was going on intervened and said, stop. You have
really?
No right to do it. Every single person
stopped. So what we see
stopped.
There is really indicative of how the whole day
Literally
panned out.
Literally every single person interfered. It was unbelievable.
Mm. It's remarkable.
It was amazing.
You also did, I don't think we showed much of it there, but you also did women that were wearing the...
Yes, the hijab.
And they got the same reaction.
The same reaction. Even there was one amazing scene. I don't know if you guys showed it, but there was a group of schoolgirls that came to stop the harassment from taking place, and by the time they had got there, another group of girls had already came to protect her. So it was truly inspirational.
Yeah.
Truly
so,
inspirational.
So when you set out to conduct this experiment, what was your aim really? What were you hoping to say to people or to teach people, or were you just hoping to learn?
To be honest, it started off with a concern. With all the Islamophobic attacks we've seen in the past few weeks, we were concerned, how deep is this issue affecting Australians? So we went out there to actually test the waters. So we staged a false harassment
social
on a Muslim woman.
Yeah.
And then we couldn't believe the response we got. So we were surprised. We learned from this that Australians are tolerant, respectful, and that accepting of others, absolutely beautiful.
Mm. The other thing I was really proud of was really how gentle most people were when they were saying to you to stop doing it.
Yeah.
You know, just though they were mostly saying, just keep walking, mate.
That's
beautiful. Well, I almost got bashed many times. So we had to cut those parts out. But it was, at the same time, it was very inspirational to see so many people stand up and speak up for these people.
It's so beautiful. Cause
it was definitely worth it.
Mm.
But we did get some responses in that direction.
You hear a lot of people say, you know, particularly women who are wearing a hijab or a niqab or something, that quite often the intolerance that they see on the street is unspoken. So they won't see someone, you know, verbally abusing them, but they'll see people staring at them or avoiding them or, you know, shielding their children from them. How do you kind of address that, I wonder?
I think it's very important to state that this experiment doesn't say that Islamophobia doesn't occur. Mm. In fact, it does occur. We've heard of countless stories where it does happen, but the vast majority of Australians do not welcome it. Mm. And I think this video is proof of it. It is not welcome. Islamophobia, hatred against Muslims, which is unjustified, is not welcome in this country. And it's absolutely beautiful.
And perhaps that is in the minority.
It's a minority of just probably bigots that have no idea what they're doing, or they probably never met a Muslim in their life or never picked up a Quran in their life to actually judge these people.
What we tell the rest of the world is that just how Muslims don't deserve to be judged by the acts of a few, Australians at large should not be judged by the comments of a few.
What a fantastic statement. You've already had 100,000 views on this since yesterday. I mean, that's huge, guys. Yeah. You know, amazing.
Thank you so much.
What are you hoping to achieve?
We just really want to crush Islamophobia. We want to make people see Islam for what it really is. That's why this video was actually made for our Islamic Awareness Week, which is on October 13th at Macquarie University. We want people to learn about Islam and get rid of this, you know, unjustified hatred, which is baseless.
So in that Islam Awareness Week,
yes,
what sort of things you'll be doing to broaden people's knowledge and understanding of Islam?
We're going to teach people about the true Islamic values. Like, people are always talking about, you know, what's happening overseas, but we want to talk to people about the Islamic mate instead of the Islamic.
Sure.
We want to people, like, your neighbour that's
Islamic
a Muslim.
Hate. Exactly.
Your neighbour that's a Muslim. Find out about us. Find out about our values of tolerance, respect and acceptance of one another, which is also Islamic values as well as the Australian values.
Well, Kamal Abir, congratulations
Thank
on a
so
terrifically
much.
Moving piece there. As you said, 100,000 views since yesterday. After this morning, probably be 100,012 by the time you get home. I mean, you know, such is the nature of our audience.
Because our mums might watch. So.
Yeah, that's
we,
right. You
know. We encourage everyone to watch the video and share it with their friends.
Good on.
Everyone has a role to play.
Thanks for coming. And we've got the video on our website if you want to have a look at it.